All right, hello, CSU Pueblo Sabo fans. I'm here with head coach Christy Zanani beginning the 2015 season this upcoming weekend. Coach, thanks for taking the time to speak with us about the upcoming season.
Thanks for having me here.
The Pack will begin a 10-game road trip this weekend to open the 2015 campaign at the Leadoff Classic in Tucson, and your opponents in the three-day tournament all made the NCAA regionals last season. What will facing such strong opposition do for your team's confidence early on?
I think biggest thing we've been preaching to our team is you got to play the best to be the best. And what's a better opportunity than coming out right at the bat with Dixie, who made it to the top four? And I think we've been working hard at getting to this point. Our girls are ready to start playing, and we'll see where we match up.
Okay, and the Thunderbolts also will face the defending national champion West Texas A&M at the West Texas Woodward Invitational in 2 weeks. What kind of experience will that bring for the girls playing at their stadium and in that environment?
Well, it's always a great experience for us going down to Texas and playing them there. I think West Texas's fans, they bring a whole different atmosphere to softball. They rally on the pitchers, the whole team, and I know it's going to be even bigger this year just because of what they've done. They're a great team in general, but after winning that national championship, it's going to be a great experience for our team, but especially when we go in there and just match up with them and see where we're at.
Okay, and heading into your third season as the head coach and coming off a successful season from a year ago, having finished second in the RMAC, expectations remain high for this season, having been picked to finish second again in the RMAC according to the preseason poll. What will a strong non-conference schedule do for your team when you finally do enter conference play?
I think it's going to play a huge part, especially just depending on how we come off of that. We're prepared to go into this tough schedule, and coming off of that, we should have that confidence to build in. We know we have a good team. It's just a matter of where our players see themselves. We see them as a great team, but now they need to take it to that next step and go above what we've been last year. Yeah, we've been good. Yeah, we've been there, but we know we're better than that, and now it's about showing that.
Okay, and if you can, talk about your returners from last season. There are 10 upperclassmen, including 5 seniors, on this year's team. What will be expected from those players to guide the new faces and incoming freshmen?
We've talked to them about this whole thing last year, that we shouldn't be missing a beat. We were coming from last year, we were there, we weren't satisfied with how we ended the season, and we're not taking any steps back. We're continuing to get better every day.
Okay, and if you can, take us through some of your positional areas, starting with the pitching. Kelly Henry was last season All-RMAC selection, and again, she was a preseason All-RMAC selection. How does the pitching rotation shape up this year?
We have depth this year, so we're looking at 5 pitchers this year. We have Kelly and Maddie. They were our big part last year. I see them being a big part again. And then I have Lexi Martindale coming in, and Ivana Bayrano, one of my seniors. I think they all can do the job, so it's nice to have that depth and them to be able to pitch anytime I need them.
Okay, and then shifting over to position players, you have a lot of players who have started 2 or 3 years. How is that experience going to benefit the team?
I think it's huge with the experience that they have. They've gotten better each year, and we've reached that point to where I'm excited about this season. Our girls are excited. They've come together as a whole unit, and they're starting to believe in it. And it's taken those few years to finally come together, and I'm just kind of excited to see what the season holds.
Okay, and as always is the case with softball, with infield defense so important, with bunts and slaps, etc., you have Alexis Snyder and Mariah Turney up the middle. How nice is it to have those veterans in the middle?
I love having those two, but especially having Lex in there. She's been taking control of the infield, and her and Rye work so well together. You don't have to say anything. They just communicate right there, and it's like the unwritten thing. They have some kind of bond, and it's nice because they've already played together. This is their second. They're going off of it, and it's great to build off of that.
And of the starters last year, you have 7 of your 9 hitters back. Are we going to see the same starters, or is there some competition here and there with the newcomers?
You're going to see a few of those starters, but there's definitely some competition and some newbies that are going to be making their way in that rotation, and it's going to be a fight for the starting 9.
And speaking of the new players, who stands out Who stands out as someone to watch and keep an eye out this season?
I think Lissa Ubram. She's going to be our starting third baseman this year, and she can play short. She can play third. She can play basically anywhere, and her bat's really what's coming along, and she's going to be one that you're going to want to watch for sure.
Some of the strengths of this year's team. What is the team going to be good at when we come out and see them play?
I think this year our strengths are going to be our pitching is going to be strong this year. Our defense is looking great, but I think just improving on what we did last year, like not having those ups and downs, they're mentally prepared this year. And you can tell that mental toughness has really been preached this year, and they're going to go above and beyond.
All right, very good. I think that about sums it up for the 2015 season preview here with head coach Chrissy Zanani. Coach, thank you for your time, and good luck this weekend and this season.
Thank you.